So now I'm just going to take a sample of the rabbit to get it tested for RHD. So in the sampling kit, there's a small vial with some preservative liquid in it that the liver or the leg bone needs to go into. If you have gloves, it's recommended that you get some gloves. You can just use food grade gloves that you buy from the supermarket. It'll just help protect contaminating samples between rabbits if you find more than one rabbit, and also just keep your hands clean. Most people should have scissors handy, so I'm going to show you how to do this with scissors. Just want to pick up the skin and make a cut. Okay. Try not to cut the intestines because they smell. Looking for a piece of liver. This is the liver, the large red organ on top. So get your tube. If you've got someone to help you, it makes it easier. Cut off a piece of liver. That size. Put it into the tube. Make sure it's completely submerged. Make sure that if you've got multiple rabbits, the rabbit that you're sampling matches the label that we've provided for you on the tube. Back into the case and into the replied paid envelope and pop it in the post. If you get to the rabbit and there's no liver because there's already been crows or foxes that have come and eaten the rabbit, then you can use a bit of hind leg bone. It's a little bit harder to get, but there's enough virus in the leg bone for us to identify what the rabbit has died from. And try and remove as much flesh and tissue from the bone that you can. And that's all you're after. If you have an adult rabbit, the head of the bone can be a little big, so you'll need to break it off or it won't fit. And you can just snap the top and you can see the marrow on the inside. Get your sampling tube. Make sure if you do snap that head off, that end goes in first. Make sure it's all the way in. Just pop it into the bag and into the reply paid envelope. Make sure again that your sample matches the label, matches the rabbit that you've submitted for if you've got multiple rabbits. When you finish collecting the sample with the dead rabbit, you can either bury the carcass, or if you believe it does have RHD, then you're more than welcome to put it down another rabbit hole to try and spread the virus around to remove more rabbits. So just find a good entrance that doesn't have a lot of vegetation in the front, so it's obviously being used. So just place the rabbit as far as you can down the hole. You want it to decompose inside the warren so that other rabbits come in contact with it.